Bassam Al-Khalayli, a Jordanian from the northern city of Al-Mafraq, says he feels like a stranger in his own country. Over 100,000 Syrians live in Al-Mafraq and compete for jobs with Jordanians. For Bassam, that's meant earning a quarter of what he used to and being unable to marry his fiancé because his salary is only enough to cover rent.
This makes us depressed. One could even become suicidal. What is there to look forward to if you don't feel comfortable in your own country? We own nothing, not even the right to express ourselves.
Municipal sources in Al-Mafraq place the number of Syrians at 120,000, and that excludes the 80,000 living in Az-Za'atri camp. Rent here has skyrocketed and wages have plummeted because Syrians are willing to accept lower salaries. Jordanians say they're growing poorer and angrier.
The vast majority of Syrian refugees live in cities and towns across the country rather than in camps. The government says this is causing infrastructure to crumble and that significant funds are required to meet additional demand for services like water, sanitation, and electricity.
The UN Refugee Agency and its partners are trying to mitigate the impact of the refugee crisis by funding cleanup campaigns to improve sanitation here. An old bakery has been renovated with new equipment to triple bread production and cater to a larger population. And a Jordanian couple has been given a second floor on top of their house for hosting a Syrian widow and her children. Faris Ifrewan Nasser appreciates the help, but says Jordanians need more support.
All these aid agencies handing out things to Syrians should also help poor Jordanians. Is it a waste to give free heaters and blankets to Jordanians too?
With 160 ongoing projects in host communities across Jordan, the UN Refugee Agency says even more projects will come.
The objective for 2014, as part of the regional response plan, which is going to be several billion dollars, is that the international community provides much more support to the host communities.
Replacing rundown infrastructure due to a growing population of Syrians and attempts to mitigate the frustration of Jordanians could only mean one thing. Hundreds of thousands of Syrians here aren't returning to their country anytime soon. Nisreen Al-Shamaili, Al Jazeera, Al Mafraq.